presented by Sprint.
Thanks for joining us at halftime. We got a terrific game going on at Pepsi Center. At the midway point, the Pacers playing well. The NBA pecking order still being determined. They're looking to get over 500 and to stay there. And still in it, the Nuggets hanging around. They continue to dice up teams with passing, fluid play. It's beautiful team basketball. Getting it done early, Paul Millsap. He's done everything you'd want from one of your big men, finding and hitting those high percentage shots in the paint. Let's start by looking and seeing what's on tap in the NBA. For the Celtics, they'll be up against the Rockets out in Houston. That gets going 7:30 Eastern. And one game also on the docket, over at Quicken Loans Arena, the Cavaliers will face off against the Mavericks. That one gets started at 8 Eastern. And back to Pepsi Center we go, as the third quarter is just about to get underway.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
I get those goosebumps every time.
The second half just about to get going here.
Throw that to the side. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, you throw that to the side.
The Nuggets trail by 8. Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. So on the floor for Denver. Paul Millsap out there with Porter. And it's Harris in at the shooting guard.
All the points these defenders are allowing inside is inexcusable. That's 5 baskets in a row, and they've all been practically lay-ins.
Yeah, they've got to harden and toughen up down there, guys.
Turner's checked in for McDermott. And that one falls for Millsap. Pacers leading by 5. Brogdon. He's covered by Murray. Lever. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
How about that? Breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk.
A nice way to pad that lead a little more.
Yeah, you got that right.
Lever's gone 3 of 7, shooting from the floor. Now Murray. And cut it from 19 feet away. He's got 7.
And he's the type of player who, you know, when he gets it going, is almost impossible to cool down. Coaches will call a timeout sometimes just to take away some of the momentum that he provides for that club.
And, you know, he is an extremely skilled player attacking off the dribble, too. I mean, he's got a great pull-up jumper as well, Steve.
Land soft on the front of the rim and drops. Warren's got 12 points in the game. The Nuggets trail by 7. Here's Jukic. And that one is stuffed right through.
Cutting into the lead with a huge one-hand throwback.
That's how they get your team back into it.
Yes, sir. That may put a little life back into this team.
Rocket. And Turner throws it down.
Carving out some space and eating a little glass at the offensive end while he's doing it.
You got it with a ferocious follow.
Yeah, but just another day at the office for him. That's what he does.
And the pass to Murray. The dish to Porter. 18 feet out. They get it back. Jukic off on the layup. Pacers leading by 7. To the inside. Warren, good. Warren's got 4 points in the quarter.
Everything's going right now. 4 for 5 shooting, 80%. They got their offense clicking.
Here's Porter. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
He feeds it to Warren. Uses both hands to slam it down.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Well, they already had him staggered. Now all of a sudden they're throwing some haymakers. I need the
time. And time calls it. The Nuggets decide to talk it over.
Well, just too many easy buckets, you know, in and around the paint. So he wants to put a stop to it. His timeout is going to be used to try to tighten up the defense.
Guys, at this level, they won't miss often if you keep giving up looks inside. And they're paying for that right now. Good timeout.
Well, he's been a real positive factor for them. one today, although, you know, as a team, they've had a lot of negatives mixed in there as well.
For Indiana, they've gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second half. Tremendous efficiency. There's the pick. Brogdon. And there are the Pacers with another bucket.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
The Nuggets trail by 10. He dishes it to Porter. On the high post, he throws it. Porter's got 12 in the game. Clock keeps going. 3 minutes into the second half now. Timeout call, the Pacers. With this break, let's show you the teams that led the league in assists last year. Fourth, the Nuggets.
Yeah, wonderful passing team, and it was the kind of basketball that fans love to watch. Very unselfish.
He kicks it to Warren. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. He's had 4 chances at the line, made them all.
You know, last game he turned in a really nice performance at the charity stripe.
Yeah, it really stands out when you look back at the numbers from that one.
Guys, I thought he got into a groove last year at the charity stripe, and I thought he maintained it deep into the season as well.
That misses, so he splits the free throws. The Nuggets trail by 9. Harris misses.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job. We're seeing him bring that shooting percentage up now, guys. The first half was a struggle for him.
For Indiana, they have been getting it done at the line, 10 for 12. And the free throw good from Warren. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Murray, the pass to Millsap. Right side, Millsap. Here's Jokic.
Blocking foul, hold on.
Jeremy Lawrence checked in for the Pacers. Harris with it. Now defended by Warren. And another miss by Denver.
I think it's going to be tough for them to trim this deficit if he keeps missing those kinds of shots. Yes, I mean, they need his points.
Just seems like they're finding an open lane to the hoop every time down. It's 5 buckets in a row for them in the paint.
Yeah, on the flip side, Steve, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Porter. Pacers with the rebound. Warren's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Brogdon, guarded by Harris. Can't get it to go. And Denver the other way now. And finished off by Porter.
Tell you what, Kevin, they'd love to see him get a lot more of those opportunities.
Mark, that deficit will go away quickly if he does.
Man, I like the way he capped that drive off, guys, with the one-hand punch.
Pacers leading by 11. This is to Warren. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. Warren's got 12 points in just the second half.
Their prowess inside has been tremendous, guys. I mean, it's been no contest down on the low block.
And until they prove they can stop them, I mean, they ought to continue to pound it in low.
Lamb, good. Lamb's got 5.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Yeah, absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding. They are piling up the assists.
And it's slammed in by Millsap.
Up high and down hard with the one hand.
Got a little extra force with that one, didn't he?
Yes, sir. I think he's hoping to kind of get his teammates going a little bit, fellas.
Kicks it to Warren. Some nice passing here by Indiana. Shot denied. 2-on-1 as they jump out on the break. Here's Porter. Buries the jumper to finish the break. He's got 17.
He always knows where his teammate's going to be, and Kevin, that will let him put the ball where he wants it, right waiting for him.
It's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the bucket.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
That whistle got a big response from this crowd, and it is not a favorable one, let's say.
I'll tell you what, the fans can't believe that they made that call.
And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession.
That is not a difficult pass. You'd think they could keep it in bounds.
And Indiana making a change here. Turner's checked in. Holiday feeds it to Turner, and that one's drained from the low block. Turner's got six in the quarter.
Beautiful feed off the bounce to his teammate there. Nicely done. How about a look at the Pacers and where they ranked in the NBA last season? Second in field goal percentage, fifth in fewest turnovers per game, and they were in the top 10 in assists. A lot of good passers on this team, and guys that are willing to make the extra pass as well.
I think what jumped out to me was the shooting more than anything, Clark, because this is a team in the top five in field goal percentage, and they were very unselfish. They were efficient offensively, constantly looking for every good shot available.
Harris misses.
And I think the work on the boards has been a big key for their success in this game, guys.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, it's been total control on the boards for them.
Passes it to Lamb. There's a minute 34 left in the third quarter. Shot clock at 5. Right. And it's blocked by Porter.
He's still looking for his first three-pointer of the second half after making just one in the first.
Shot is no good. The Pacers making a switch here. TJ. Indiana leading by 15. Number 11, Millsap covering. Beyond the arc. Martin with the rebound.
He has just disappeared this quarter, not making a mark at all offensively.
I'm sure he's ready to put this quarter behind him and quickly.
Here's Jukic. Connection, the follow-on jumper. 14 points for him.
I like the way he's not forcing anything, taking advantage of what the defense is giving. He's been a key contributor for them this quarter.
There's 37 seconds left to play in the third. Rodden, defended by Morris. Inside, down to 5 on the shot clock. No luck. Nice deep.
They've been able to get out to this lead without really getting a very reliable performance out of him from the field. You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there.
And he misses the fast break layup. Here's Barton. And a miss there on the triple. Picked him clean. Got it up. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game.
Friday night, December 11th, the San Antonio Spurs go up against the New Orleans Pelicans. It's a Southwest Division battle. Don't miss it.
And we welcome you back as we get going here in the fourth quarter. The final quarter of play can change everything. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for Indiana.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
And one other thing I would add is the mid-range game has been really impressive. I mean, they are showing great touch on some of those 15, 17-footers.
On the court right now for the Pacers. Here's Porter. Foul call. Looked like the D didn't get there in time, and he'll shoot free throws. Here's a look at what's coming up for the Nuggets. Following this game, they hit the road. They'll take on the Knicks in New York. It's game one of a three-game road trip. He misses the free throw. Jeremy Lamb's checked in for Indiana. And the second free throw, good. Pacers leading by 12. Always going up for the alley-oop here. Up high to stuff the alley-oop.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
You know, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
Yeah, what a beautiful connection on that play.
Porter passes to Murray. He passes it to Porter. Hands it from downtown. Porter's got 4 points now on the quarter.
And that kind of defense is just not going to cut it, because they have to get a hand in his face.
And Indiana shooting at 51%. Really solid. Here's Turner. Boom, he jams it straight down.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. And it's Harris off the rim.
Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim. You're right.
If he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will really start shrinking.
The Pacers have gone 2-3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. And there's the feed to Lamb. Pass to Turner. There's the dish to Lamb. Shot clock at 6. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Dropped it. Buries the long-range jumper. And the Pacers lead by 14.
That's his first three-pointer of the half. Remember, he did make one in the first half as well.
Murray, the pass to Harris. Martin dishes to Millsap. Porter. Backs in. Deflected. He wants to get the Millsap and does. Takes it up with both hands and rips it down.
Another good offensive possession for him. He's trying to shoulder the load here for his team.
Pacers leading by 12. Timeout called, the Pacers. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sidelines.
Kevin, the head coach for the Pacers had some instruction for his guys during that break. He said to them, the lead we've got now is nice, but I want to make it even nicer. This is when we put the hammer down. It doesn't look like he's ready to back off just yet, guys.
Thank you, Doris.
He's really done a nice job taking advantage of his opportunities in this half.
Here's Porter. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Some outstanding numbers in this one for Porter. He's got 21 points, and he's got 9 points from behind the arc.
Yeah, that's been an important part of his game today. He's made his open looks.
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Knocked loose and stolen by Murray. Gives him the lead pass, and he drops it in from the low post. Harris has got 4 points in the quarter. Pacers leading by 10. The pass to Warren. Guarded by Porter. From 10 feet out. And it's Denver with the rebound. Here's Murray. He feeds it to Porter. And out of bounds as the Pacers gain possession. And a chance now to check out the schedule for Indiana. They'll be off to Brooklyn for a meeting with the Nets after this one. And that's game 4 of 4 out on the road for them.
Well, you know, the fans out in Brooklyn desperately hoping for their team to win that one.
Tries to save it. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession. The Nuggets trail by 10. Jokic defended by Warren. And that basket's going to count. Moses gets the goaltending call right there.
He thought he had that one clean, but the refs saw it differently. They'll count the basket.
The Pacers have gotten 4 of their 6 shots to fall so far here in the fourth. A pretty nice efficiency there. And pushing it up, here's Denver.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yes, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Well, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Great open look there.
For Denver, they've gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth, going 6 for 7. And that one's good by Porter. Porter's got 27 points.
It's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint. I guess the good news is they're taking away the outside shot.
Well, you know what? It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they're going to allow inside looks as easy as that.
No coverage that time. Warren's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Well, it took him a long time to get that three-point range. Maybe this will get him going.
Turner with the steal. Lamb with the ball. There's a good screen. Warren. Off target with his three.
Not much of a pick there. Unless you're going to get a body on somebody, you're really not going to free anybody up for a shot.
Pass to Murray. Here's the three. Rebounded by Lamb. Lamb's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. The Pacers making a switch here. Pacers leading by 9. Rocket. He's covered by Murray. Here's Warren. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Warren's got 31.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Denver's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. And Millsap, here we go. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
What a performance from Millsap here. 16 points and a pretty good rebounding performance from him also.
Yeah, he's been establishing terrific position, boxing out very well and battling hard for every rebound.
The Pacers have gone 7 of 10 shooting the ball since the start of the fourth quarter. Here's the screen. He dishes it to Warren. And the three ball is good. Warren's got 10 points in the quarter.
He's not going to miss many of those, if any. Not when he's got that much room.
Here's Porter. Goes to the fadeaway and pins it.
He's simply a machine at the offensive end. I wonder how far behind they'd be if he wasn't having this kind of quarter.
Rotman. He's covered by Murray. Here's Turner. Banked in off the glass. Turner's got 10 points in just the second half.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
Yeah, it's something we haven't seen much of at the other end of the floor, though.
Lever, guarded by Harris. Lever, and a little luck that time, but it drops. And the Pacers lead by 15.
Man, an even stronger second half. Tremendous efficiency at the offensive end of the floor.
Yeah, I know you know about how the basket can seem like it's 10 feet wide when you're in the zone. That's where they are right now.
1:53 left in the fourth quarter. Outside Turner. Number 11, Millsap covering. Shot's good by Turner. Turner's got 6 here in this quarter.
Really good awareness right there on the assist.
He kicks it to Porter. Three-pointer. It's rebounded by Indiana. Turner's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active.
And that's pretty much how this game has gone. They've controlled the boards and look to come away with the win right here.
Buries it down low.
They're straying away from the three-point game here in the second half. And that's fine as long as they're on the lead and they're getting good shots. They've decided not to take nearly as many three-pointers in this half.
Ryan Hyatt throwing down the hard one-hander.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
And he does it as well as anyone. Tremendous skill in the air.
Boy, their defense making an impact here late, Kevin.
And straight off the steel card, the perfectly run fast break ends in a slam dunk.
That could be a huge four-point swing in this game.
And 101 left in the fourth quarter. Brockton, he's covered by Murray. Dishes it to Warren. And Turner throws it down.
Well, guys, tonight they came in here and really dictated the terms of the engagement, which is very difficult to do as the visitors.
You're right. That's not usually the way things work in the NBA. It's a great win, and no question, it's going to be a happy plane ride out of here.
Kicks to Porter. Buries it from three-point range. Porter's got 34 points.
Looks like they're going to finish strong, but just aren't enough ticks left on the clock.
Well, Steve, it's a good run they're having now, but they just waited too long to have it.
Now, no way you can come back from this deficit.
Just not enough time left on the clock.
Another three for Denver. Porter. There's 21 seconds left in the game. And Indiana can just let the clock run down here. Indiana making some changes. Out of bounds, Indiana will retain possession.
12 seconds of the shot clock. 12.
Number 7, and we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there.
It'll be a jump ball.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. So it's Indiana picking up the win. They came, they saw, they conquered.
Hey, Kevin, to me, any win is a good win.
That about does it for Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, Doris Burke, and the rest of our great crew. This is Kevin Harlan saying so long and thanks for watching. Now, here's our Jordan Player of the Game.